I met the Indian guy who speaks Japanese very well on the airplane.
Suddenly I found a person who was sitting next to my seat, so I never thought I'll talk to him also. But suddenly I just said him hello and hi in Japanese and all. We started a conversation.
And we promised, okay, we meet again in the India. I lived in Japan. You know, my father is a dentist, and when I was 13, you know, I'm not interested in school, so I dropped out, you know, high school when I was 16, and then I didn't go anywhere. I just stay in my house, and because you know, I was looking for myself.
I was born and brought up in Delhi. I did my education from Delhi University. I did political science, but I wanted to do something different because English speaking guys we could find very easily in Delhi. But I wanted to do something special in life, especially with languages and all. And from my childhood I was very much impressed with Japanese culture and all. So I wanted to learn Japanese, but it was very difficult language. Anyhow, I entered university, and in 2 years program I learned Japanese.
So I watched every day American film and the Chinese film and the Indian film, any country films, you know, every day, maybe one day, 4 and 5 films in my home theater. After 3 years, you know, fortunately I could find my job, film business job. I never get a salary from my, you know, from my work. Just, you know, I ask the production manager, please hire me. But I don't need money because I can live. I can live by myself. My father is a dentist, so he take care of me. So just I need experience. So please hire me. And he hire me. As a camera assistant and editor.
At that, in those time, very few Japanese people came to India. Only we had Sony and very big companies like Suzuki and all. But anyhow, I landed in Bangalore as a Japanese interpreter. So I started my Japanese career in 97 in Bangalore. I was in Bangalore for 5 years. That too, being a vegan, I had a hard time because I don't drink, I don't smoke and all. This is the reason I entered spiritual tours of Sai Baba. So I used to escort people who are going to temples and who had the faith and who knew Hinduism. So moreover, I started my career from inborn tours from Japan, spiritual tours, you can say.
I wanted to go United States. I suddenly, you know, it came, you know, from my heart. Oh, I want to go United States to be producer. So I prepared to visit United States maybe 4 years, 5 years. I traveled a lot, another country. So I visited South Asia and Europe. And then when I was 33, I went Philippines for studying English. Maybe 6 months I stayed Philippines, and after that, you know, I visited the United States. Maybe I was 34.
Then after 5 years, I moved back to Delhi where my family was there. Then I started freelancing. Then I, moreover, 2-3 years I did some interpretation for Hitachi and very big companies. Then I landed with my own company as a travel agency. New Metro Travels, I started my own company. Then after New Metro Travel, 5-6 years, I thought only travel agencies won't fulfill my dreams. So I started a new classes, a new theme, which was not happening in India, Hindi classes for Japanese in Rishikesh. And moreover, yoga, Hindi, it was a package type of tours.
And I went English school in Los Angeles, but I didn't like to study, so I dropped out suddenly, and I wanna get a connection in film business, So suddenly I thought, okay, I will join a fitness club in West Hollywood. And suddenly I met some good guy. His name is Austin Stowell. Austin Stowell is he played in a Spielberg film, and he introduced me his producer friend. His name is Jordan Forley. He said to me, "If you want to be producer, I can help you." "Oh, really?" I said to him. "Oh, okay. Please teach me how to be producer in Hollywood." He said, "Read a script every week, 8 script. I can send you maybe a lot of script." He sent me maybe 200, 300 scripts. So I was reading every day script.
So I landed with a hotel called Hotel Tapovan Villa in Rishikesh, where I taught Hindi, English to Japanese and yoga lessons, especially for Japanese. It was purely 101% Japanese guest house. So I took care of all Japanese, and my staff also basic Japanese they knew, and I was there to look after Japanese needs. So I had a good business 5-6 years. Then again I had to travel a lot to Japan, being an interpreter and support company. I was having a support company for Japanese in Delhi.
I was reading a script, but you know, I'm Japanese and my English is not very well. I needed help to read a script together. But I don't have a friend in Los Angeles. So I decided, okay, I have to get my English teacher personally. Yeah, also fortunately, I could get my girlfriend. She helped me and she teach me, how to speak English. Fortunately, I could get a celebrity friend, and I have an opportunity to meet some producers. But it happened bad. I was deported from the United States, March 27. They asked me, "Do you work in the United States?" "No, I don't work. I never get a salary. I never get money from any person, any company in here." But they doubt me. You work in the United States. You have only student visa. So yeah, I was deported.
So I had to travel thrice or four times to Japan. Anyhow, while traveling, I met so many people. I discussed with many people about India, potential of India, because India is 9 times bigger than Japan. But I couldn't convince anybody because of the problems we were having in India and the real India. So nobody was able to accept the working conditions which were in India. So the moment came when I was very much frustrated that I didn't want to do something in Japan because of my family. I wanted to do something in India, but that too with Japanese people. Being a Japanese interpreter, I love Japan, I like Japan. So I wanted to do something in life with Japanese.
I came back to Japan and I stayed my parents' house 3 months. Almost 3 months I stayed. I didn't go anywhere. And suddenly I thought, oh, I wanna go India. I never been. Only India I never been. My girlfriend also, she loved India culture, but she never been. So I introduced, I invite her to come India, and we went, we visited together India first time June 19th.
So the moment came when I was frustrated, I was traveling back to India. Suddenly I found a person who was sitting next to my seat. He was busy shooting. He was having a small iPhone camera. He was shooting around. So I never thought I'll talk to him also. But suddenly I just said him hello and hi in Japanese and all. We started a conversation.
I met the Indian guy who speaks Japanese very well on the airplane. And we promised, okay, we meet again in the India. Please give me number and we change, our numbers.
So he was staying in Hotel Radisson in Dwarka. So I told, if you have any problem, you can contact me. So I went back to my hotel Rishikesh.
I traveled with my girlfriend just 1 week. But I didn't contact him just that 1 week because I enjoyed with my girlfriend. But suddenly she was upset because she loved India before, but she never been India, real India. She didn't know. And so she always upset because weather is very hot, almost 50 degrees every day. And also she's American, so she doesn't like spicy food. So always she was upset. And she said suddenly, I don't like to visit anywhere in India. I want to stay in my room. I don't go anywhere. Okay, but we have 1 week. So, okay, I leave you, okay? I asked her, she said, please allow me, leave me alone, she said. I called that guy who met on the airplane. His name is Naveen.
In the evening, he called me that, let's meet. But since I was in Rishikesh, around 265 kilometers from Delhi, so I couldn't come the same night. I told him, okay, let's meet tomorrow. Anyhow, the next day, I boarded a train without any reservation because I wanted to meet him at any cost.
And I asked Naveen, can you show me Bangalore? Because, I want to do some business in Bangalore. Yeah, some IT business. So please show me. And he said, okay, I can follow you. I can guide you. So we visited Bangalore.
Since I had good connections in Bangalore, so both of us, we visited IT park in Bangalore, especially Whitefield and all. So he loved Bangalore very much, especially food of Bangalore, IT sector and everything which was happening in Bangalore, especially the environment and all. Then again, being an Indian, I told him that it's not very easy to start a IT business in India very soon. So we needed some time. But then again, Ken, he's very fast. He's like bullet train and I'm like a local train. So we took a middle part. He told, okay, I agree with you. Let's start with some F&B business, food and beverages business.
So I changed my mind. Okay, I will find the food business in India. Naveen had one idea. Because I'm Japanese. I know Japanese culture. I know Japanese food. But I never thought, I show Japanese food to India. I never thought like that. But he's an Indian, so he said, Indian people like Japanese food, and you don't understand because you are Japanese. So he has one idea. That is tofu idea, tofu business. Paneer and tofu is almost twin. It looks like the same. So, okay, I want to join this business with you. And then we researched a supermarket in India. And we tasted Indian tofu. We bought a lot of Indian local market tofu and tasted, but it was super bad. And, smell is super, really stinky, and texture is too hard. This is not the tofu. What's that? I don't know. But they call tofu. we can get the opportunity because the tofu market is a Indian local tofu is not good. So just we should bring Japanese tofu from Japan. First, I established the Japanese company in Japan, named Takeda Global Service. And then I established the Indian company in India. We are finding a tofu machine in India, but the Indian machine and the Chinese machines are not good. Looks like a toy. Cannot separate okara and the soya milk.
We had to improve import a Japanese machine, because with Indian machine we won't be able to solve the purpose. Because if we want the authentic tofu, it has to be a Japanese machine, not a Taiwanese, not a Chinese. It has to be 100% made in Japan. Mr. Ken, he did a lot of survey. Five times he went to Japan. He went to different parts of Japan just looking for automatic machines and tofu machines. He did a lot of homework. Finally, we landed in Masei Tofu Machine, which is a very good company. Apart from a company, it's a training house, I can call. So they were ready to give us machines and give us a training in India. And I had also visited the same company with him. Both of us, we had a chance to visit that company. I did my training in tofu. For 5 days I was there. So the main thing was learning. I couldn't have any Indian food, because he said it was not our lunch, it was a learning. I was in Japan to learn about various kind of tofus. So always since breakfast till night, it was almost tofu. If I had to drink something, it was tofu smoothie and all. When I came back to India and we prepared tofu in India, so I could know, distinguish what is Indian tofu and what is Japanese tofu. Right now in our production, the Masei team, they came here, they taught our engineers.
Indian employee, my employee can make tofu by themselves. That's amazing. And now, and also my company is the first time India Japanese owner and Indian employee. Indian employee make Japanese tofu. That's first time India. We have a lot of distributor now. We distribute to hotels and hospitals, schools, and some. Our company is in Manesar, but we deliver to Noida and Rishikesh and Chandigarh and Dharamshala. And I'm happy. Maybe next month I will visit the Dalai Lama to bring my tofu.
Our mothers, sisters are lacking protein, multivitamins and all. Because being a vegetarian, I don't like milk also. Being a vegan, I cannot drink milk. So very few things which I can have. If I have paneer, then again some problems are there, it's heavy and all. So tofu is the best substitute. Low cholesterol, full of proteins. So if I have tofu, I can have tofu smoothie, I can have tofu burji, tikka, and I can take my silken tofu salad directly. And what we want is tofu shall reach each and every household. Each and every mother should have tofu and lead a very healthy and peaceful life.
That was my story, how I am bringing Japanese tofu to India. Please share it and leave a comment. And if you have a question, please send us your question. We can answer any question.
And if you would like to buy our fresh tofu, you can just order it online. We shall deliver it at your doorstep. Thank you very much. Namaste.
Arigatou gozaimasu.